The magic of Christmas is a child making a wish and it coming true.
Go ahead, Aiden.
Well, share whatever it is, all right?
All right.
For a kite! Thank you, thank you!
Well, don't thank us. Think Father Christmas.
I seem to recall after giving you last year's payment, not all of it reached Lord Rockford. And I had men even more foul than you show at my door.
Not to blame if you can't add your coin properly.
Do you steal from every person you collect or just us?
You're going to give me the payment or do you need persuading?
I'm not giving you anything. I shall deliver my payment to Lord Rockford himself.
I don't think our lord visits many men in the dungeon. Arrest him!
I'll get the money. Just don't hurt her.
I wouldn't dream of hurting her. Not when I can get such a fair price for another child in the mines. Get them in the wagon!
No! No!
Get the girl. We'll make 10 times as much from just one of these dragon eggs.
You, girl, give us the eggs.
No, I won't!
Move, girl.
Coward!
Until finally, the dragon fell and the knight was victorious. The villagers cheered. We love you.
You'll be safe here. I brought you some worms to eat while you rest. Stay off of that wing until you feel better.
Where did you learn to do that?
My mother taught me when I was about your age.
What is it?
Dragons.
You to take the warning bells a little more seriously, Aiden, especially with what happened to your parents.
I'm sorry, Sister Lenora.
Now go find the twins and make sure they are shuttering the windows properly instead of hanging out of them. And bring them down for supper.
Can you see that? I can't. Where is it?
Scoot over.
No, you. I can't see.
Will you two knock it off and close that thing before you get us all cooked?
You're not the boss of us.
Yeah.
Hey! You could have killed us! Bring that to die!
Don't be silly, Aiden. You're safe here.
Talking to yourself again?
No. I was...
Shouldn't be so jumpy. Very under...
Roslyn! You were saying?
Carrie.
Don't pick on Aiden.
Sister Lenora says supper's ready.
Ready.
is it, Aiden?
Oh, just your stocking hanging on the fireplace. It reminded me of Father Christmas.
Who?
Who's Father Christmas?
No one but a fairy tale.
That's not true.
He's real, and he's wonderful.
Aiden's right. Well, at least partially. Many years ago, even before Sister Lenora was born, there was a man named Nicholas who lived in a village not far from here. When his neighbors needed money for their daughter's wedding, he gifted it to them by dropping it down their chimney so no one would know it was him.
I remember this story.
After seeing how happy his neighbors were, he decided that was the way he wanted to live his life, bringing joy to the lives of other people. He spent his nights making secret deliveries to those in need. And even though helping grown-ups was good, what made Nicholas happiest was seeing the smiles on the children's faces when their wishes came true.
But how did he become Father Christmas?
Well, he started making a list of all the children that were good and deserved a present, not just in his town, but in every town he visited. And soon, the list got so long that it took a whole year to make all the gifts. And then he chose a special night to deliver them all.
Christmas.
That sounds familiar.
Is Christmas real?
When is it?
It's real. It's less than a week away. And now his list includes every child in the whole world. So you better be good.
And just how does he travel around the whole entire world and visit every child in one night?
He uses magic.
Really? Well, he must have lost it then. There haven't been presents in any stockings for years now. Isn't that right, Finn?
Why hasn't Father Christmas been seen in years? Why haven't we ever had a Christmas here?
Well, maybe it's because we don't believe.
We need to believe that he'll come. Make a wish in your heart for him to answer. I think it's cruel that you're getting their hopes up. I don't want any part of it.
Don't worry. I'll talk to her.
We wish for a...
Make it silent, so only he can hear.
We need to show Father Christmas that we believe.
You don't have to. He can see it in your heart.
What if we made him something?
We should make him a wreath. We can hang it on the door, and that way he'll know that he's welcome. Here, you keep gathering firewood, and I'm gonna look for some leaves and holy berries. Hello? Hello? Hello?
What are you looking for?
Holy berries and leaves.
Holy berries are poisonous.
They're not for eating. We're making a wreath for Father Christmas.
There is not going to be a Christmas, child. Not this year. Perhaps never again.
How would you know?
Can't you feel it? It's gone.
What's gone?
The magic. It's gone out of us. And all good things are turning bad. Yes. I know. I'm not pretty. I was once.
You're an elf? What happened to you?
There's a darkness in the north. Father Christmas is dying. He sent us to find the magic. But he didn't realize how quickly the elves were turning. I only made it this far because of this.
What is that?
It's a waystone. A compass. It was meant to guide me to the magic. But instead, it led me to you.
Why me?
I don't know.
I could...
But I believe you are meant to have it. Once you take it, there will be nothing left to keep the Snarl from taking me.
I don't understand, but...
Follow the compass. Find the magic. Save Christmas.
I can't do that. I can't do it by myself.
Before, we don't bid them out until they become of age. Even orphans deserve to be children.
All right. We'll take one before we leave town tomorrow, and we'll be back for the other.
I have something to show you. It's important.
So you met a real-life elf?
Yes.
And he told you Christmas wasn't coming back this year.
Well, not just this year, maybe never.
Unless you use this crystal to find the missing magic?
Well, he called it a compass, but yes.
All right, I'm in.
You really believe me, just like that?
I can't think of any better reason why you'd have a magic glowing rock.
So when do we leave?
You're all crazy. You really want to get yourself lost? And probably killed over a silly rock? You know what, you're more than welcome to do it. Alone.
No one invited you anyways.
We leave first thing in the morning. But before you make your decisions, I want you to know that this is not going to be easy. We're going to be runaways. We're going to have no money, no food, no shelter. All we have is this. And we don't even know where it's taking us.
We're going to find the lost magic.
We're going to save Christmas.
Rosalind's right. You're all crazy. But of course I'll go.
What are you all up to? Domo supper. Go wash up.
Face to face with her this early, especially with her dragon breath.
Let's carry.
Come on, let's do this.
Mm.
popcorn.
Ah, early?
Fetch the boy.
Let me get you something to drink first.
What are we going to do now?
I know another way. Follow me. Don't wake the other children.
It's over 30 feet down.
That's why we're not jumping.
Come on.
I can't leave without Roslyn. I'll buy you time by pulling up the blankets so they won't know and catch you. If I don't meet you by the edge of the woods, then go on without me.
Garrett, no, we can't go without you.
Yes, you can, Aiden. You must. Promise me you will.
I promise.
Garrett?
Now go. Hurry!
Where's Garrett?
He didn't make it out. He told me we had to go on without him. He made me promise. I understand if you want to go back.
If it's a choice between following your magic rock or facing the wrath of Sister Lenora and Father Mendo, I'll take my chances with the rock.
Which way did we go? I knew where this thing was taking us.
That's easy. North.
Well, how do you know that?
You can tell by the moss. It grows on the north side of the trees.
Oh, well, that's pretty handy.
Yeah, and at night. It's probably just a squirrel or something.
Yeah, a squirrel. But we should stay together, just in case. I think we're alone in these woods.
I have an idea.
Anytime, Murphy.
Nothing's wrong with me. You're the one who's stalking us through the woods. Now, where's Garrett?
He's not coming.
What do you mean? Is he all right?
No. He's not all right. Nothing is all right now, Aiden. We have to get moving. They're after us.
Not that way. We're heading north.
Well, if you want to go north, I know a faster way.
The river.
I assume you don't want anyone following you?
I couldn't imagine running into anyone worse.
Christmas is only 4 days away, so the faster the better.
See? What would you do without me?
Rosalind?
Imagine Sister Lenore and Father Mendel ever catching up with us.
This is going to be much faster than walking.
How did he know this was here?
Garrett used to help old man Husker haul his catch from here to the market.
Isn't he going to miss his boat?
Look at this thing. Hasn't been used in months, maybe even years. No one is going to miss it.
Is it lunchtime yet?
It looks like about midday.
What do we have to eat?
Sorry. I got hungry.
Seriously? How long did you think we were gonna be out here?
Hey, what do you bring?
I was in a hurry, okay? I thought you guys would be smart enough to bring more than just stinky cheese.
You could do a lot with stinky cheese.
Why don't we catch our own lunch?
Good idea, Ran. Do you see? If we all work together, we can make it.
What do you think you're going to catch?
This way it won't get away.
There's something in the water.
We traveled much faster than we would have through your mossy trees.
We should make a fire and set up camp. It's gonna be dark soon.
What if a dragon smells the smoke and comes for us?
I'd welcome some dragon fire.
Dragons always smell smoke. It's in their noses all the time. They won't be able to tell our fire from their own. Trust me.
We still shouldn't build a fire.
Why are you so scared, Rosalind? It's not like we've never been caught and punished before.
How does that thing work anyway? It has to be some kind of magic, right?
My mother said the magic of Christmas is a child making a wish and it coming true.
Mind if I see that?
How did you do that?
I just did what you said. I've had the same Christmas wish every year to go on an adventure. I've just thought about how I feel now that it's finally coming true.
Can we have it now?
I'd rather not see what happens after you two make a wish. Why not?
Actually, you better hold on to that. Rosalind, what was your wish?
Nothing special. What about you?
Well, mine's not very original.
An orphan wishing for a family. Welcome to the club.
Rosalind?
What are you doing here?
I was about to ask you the same question.
I just wanted to see how lost we really were.
There's something you're not telling us. You've been acting really strange. Why did you come after us? Did something happen to Garrett? I know he means a lot to you.
You have no idea what you're talking about. He would be here if he could.
What does that mean?
It means the sun's up. We need to get moving again.
Rosalind!
To death before we even get there.
Hey, I think I found something up here.
I thought you didn't believe in Christmas.
At this point, I don't know what to believe.
Can you smell that? Fresh baked bread. And bacon.
I'm not going in there.
Crystal says we go to the tavern.
I agree with Finn. The compass hasn't steered us wrong yet.
And I have?
The river.
Wouldn't it be nice to go somewhere that wasn't crawling with bugs?
I doubt there are any less bugs in there than there are out here.
But food.
Doesn't look like a very charitable place, Finn. How do you imagine paying for that food?
My good looks.
Over here. What?
We'll have a loaf of your finest bread and a flagon of water, kind sir.
And how do you plan to pay for this?
About a train.
Come on, where's your Christmas spirit?
What, you haven't noticed my decorations? That was the last man they couldn't pay for his meal. Now scram!
It's all right. It was a good idea. Excuse me, sir. Would you be so kind?
I am so sorry. I thought you looked just like our uncle. It's our mistake.
Thanks. That was about to get ugly.
You mean uglier. That guy was already pretty ugly.
Get down! Oh. What are you doing?
Yeah! Here they come. Go faster!
Help me with this!
Is this a good idea?
Apples! Pass them up here!
We need to keep moving.
No! I want answers!
All in good time.
From you. Those two are partly responsible for my parents' deaths.
Do you know them?
No.
Well, I mean, not really.
Do you think Sister Lenora sent them after us? What do they want with us?
The bounty hunters.
Oh. So which one of you got bedded out?
It was me.
What's bedded out?
When you become of age, you're old enough to become an apprentice. Kids with parents usually pick their family trade, but kids like us get sold to the highest bidder.
Garrett. They must have took him the morning we left. That's who was there. And you must have been the other one on the list. I heard them talking about it.
They were gonna send me to the mines. I couldn't stand going. I had to run away.
Well, it won't matter now who's of age and who's not.
Why not?
Well, let's put it this way. If those guys catch up to us, they're not taking you back to the orphanage.
Rosalind, they've been after you this whole time. Not us.
I put you all in danger. I was afraid.
You should have told us. We never would have left you.
I'm so sorry.
This is all very sweet. But there is a pack of ruthless bounty hunters who would have caught up to the wagon by now and noticed that we are not in it. So, unless you want to be really, really sorry, we need to go. Now.
Who are you anyway?
I'm Eric. Let's go.
Hoyt.
Finn.
Ben.
Pleasure.
Rosalind.
Thank you. So an elf gave you his waystone, just like that.
Not exactly. When he gave it to me, he changed.
Changed? Changed how?
I don't know, it was like he went dark all of a sudden. Like
all of the magic was being drained out of him. He turned into a goblin.
He told me to follow the waystone, and I did. And it led me to you. Do you know where the magic is?
I do. But it's not that simple.
What do you mean?
Father Christmas's magic comes from an orb. It's cut from the same crystal as your waystone. I used to have it, but I lost it years ago.
Lost it? But you just said you knew where it was.
When I say I lost it, I meant to someone. Or in this case, an ogre.
So without this orb thing, there's no chance of saving Christmas?
Well, I know we should be rationing this, but if we're going after an ogre, I'm gonna need my strength.
I think there's a rock in my shoe.
We have bigger things to worry about. Much bigger. I can't believe you survived to fight with an ogre.
Well, it wasn't really a fight.
What was it then, a battle of wits? Please, tell me you didn't lose to an ogre in a battle of wits.
Actually, it was a bet.
Why in the world would you make a bet with an ogre?
It's a long story. I have a plan. Do you know what ogres like to eat?
Besides children.
Yes.
We're not gonna let the ogre eat that, right?
No. It's a distraction. Quiet down, here it comes.
That's not what you said before losing your bet to him. So what does your stone do? How's it going to help bring the magic back?
Well, Father Christmas uses it to slow down time so that he can deliver presents. I mean, how do you think he did it all in one night?
Will you be able to show us?
Maybe. There, I see him. Was that supposed to be a bird call? This way! Yes.
to receive the need any help.
So is that the rock?
For the Christmas uses it to slow down time. That's how he delivers all the presents in one night.
Show us how it works.
Yeah, show us.
Well, I don't actually know that I can make it work.
Why? It's missing.
Well, I don't actually know that it works at all anymore. Ever since I laid hands on it, it's been dark.
How did you end up with this thing?
That's a long story. Look, if it's like Aiden says, and the elves are turning, then we don't have much time. Okay, we've got 2 days to get this to Father Christmas, and that's our only chance of making it work again.
All right. How do we find Father Christmas?
I was afraid you'd ask that. I can take you to the border of the north, but that's as far as I'm going.
Come on, then. Is that a field over there? Wouldn't that be easier to travel on?
A bit quicker, yes. Being out in the open like that makes this easy lunch for a dragon. Besides, those woods are home to bandits. They think that these woods are infested with goblins.
Are there goblins in these woods?
In these woods? No. No, the scariest things in these woods is us.
He doesn't seem very sure of himself. Rivers to travel. It's a good way to hide your tracks, right?
It seems like it could work. There's a lot of foul beasts lurking in that water who wouldn't think twice about turning you into chum.
Ouch. What is it?
Where are you going?
shot this little one down too.
No, don't!
Aiden is hurt.
She's an orphan, like us now. If we don't help her, no one will.
This is a bad idea. We really should be going. There is nothing we can do. Those bandits will be here any minute to make sure that that dragon is dead.
But aren't the bandits too scared to come into the woods? What about the goblins?
The only problem is there are no goblins.
Yes, there are.
Went down by the river.
Did you see that?
Don't be a coward. This way.
You're no goblin.
Isn't that sweet? A girl and a dragon. Step aside. This one's mine. I shot it down. It's mine to kill.
Then you'll have to get through me first.
Thank you.
dragon.
Are you a goblin? Who are you?
I was going to ask you the same thing.
What are you waiting for? Get out of here!
Well, it looks like you didn't have any problems here.
Well, I did run into a little trouble, but I was able to take care of it. With help.
Found you the herbs you needed.
Serwin?
That's for leaving. And that is for not saying goodbye. And it's for stealing the orb of Borealis.
Are you gonna beat the rest of us up too?
No. I only do that to thieves.
Aiden, do you care to explain what's going on? Who's your new friend?
This is Serwin. She's one of the elves from the north trying to find the Orb of Borealis, which apparently was stolen from Father Christmas by his son.
Isn't that right, Eric?
Didn't do it for me.
Well, it was still pretty selfish. You have no idea what's happening in the north, do you?
Well, I can see that it's not good.
Well, this is the least of it. The north is dying. The Snarl is back, and it is huge and dark and dangerous and growing, and for the Christmas... Your father is not doing well.
Hold on. I thought this orb thing was for delivering presents. And now the sun is destroying the north?
Yeah, I may not have been completely honest about its powers.
That is the understatement of the century. When connected to Father Christmas's staff, the orb makes time in the north run constantly slower. It has to, for the north to function.
Is that why Father Christmas has lived for so long?
Yes. And it also helps us keep the Snarl at bay. With the power to control time, it can pretty much do anything.
No, it can't.
Eric, you know that the orb can slow down time, sometimes even stop it, but nothing. Not even the orb can reverse it.
Yeah, but he didn't even try. Someone had to try.
Who?
Eric's mother died. 5 years ago. He stole the orb to turn back time and save her. Don't ever leave without saying goodbye again. Glad you came back. There isn't much time. But even now, it may be too late to save Christmas.
We failed.
There's still a chance, Aiden. But we must return the orb back to Father Christmas.
I'm afraid you'd say that.
I know it hurts, but this will help your wing heal faster.
What are we gonna do with her?
We're keeping her.
She's not going to be able to travel very far until her wings heal.
We can't wait. Tomorrow is Christmas Eve.
We can take her with us.
Dragons are meant to fly, not walk. She would never make it in the Snarl.
What is so bad about this Snarl thing?
You'll find out soon enough.
I don't like the sound of that at all.
We should get some sleep. We're going to need our rest.
You'll be safe here. You've plenty of food and water. Stay off that wing. Even though it's healing fast, no flying. You need your rest. Don't worry.
We've created a sacred bond with her. We two will always be able to find one another.
You ready to go?
We're going north. Catch up with us when you can.
It was bad.
All this in a few years.
It's gotten worse as time goes on. With no elves left to cut it back, it's gone dark and wild.
Are you sure it's a good idea for you to go in there?
Going through is the only way to the north now. We have no other choice. Gathering, closing in on us.
I've never met a full-blown goblin before, but deep down they're still elves, right?
It's not what makes us forget who we are. I feel it, pulling me.
So what do we do?
We need to stay together.
Go on my foot!
Get me out of here. Back to Father Christmas in time. The sun is already setting. It's Christmas Eve.
Father Christmas lives.
Didn't always look like this. Are you ready?
I just want to warn you. You're not going to like what you see.
Mm-hmm.
father?
Alive, he's just old. It was only the magic of the orb that kept his body young. Without it, he's just a 1,000-year-old man.
Father, I've brought back the orb.
Come on, children. Let's give them some time alone.
Father, I know how angry you must be. Did I know that there is nothing I can say to fix the damage I've done?
Here's our last hope.
At least I get to spend my last Christmas with you. I can't believe we came all this way for nothing. We can't just give up.
There's nothing else to do. And it's all my fault.
Christmas is lost forever.
No, it can't be lost. If we give up, then it really is lost. But we already know that the magic, it's not completely gone.
Maybe not yet. But without a whole lot of magic, Father Christmas won't ever wake up.
Our Christmas wishes. Rand, hoy!
We got our dragon.
I never told you. But my wish was to be free from the life I would have been forced into. And I guess that came true too. Can't imagine those goons finding me all the way up here.
And I guess my wish came true a long time ago.
And what was that?
A family.
I don't know. I mean, even with all those wishes, look. My father hasn't stirred.
Not yet. But they're right about the wishes. Who knows how many it will take. But look how powerful mine was in the snow.
When did your wish come true in the snow?
When you said you needed me.
All right, Eden. I believe. What's the plan?
Eric, get the list from your father. Rand, Hoy, Finn, go help Samuel prepare the presents. Rosalind, you're with me.
Thank you.
we gonna pull the sleigh without magic?
You sure this thing's gonna work?
No, but it's not impossible to imagine that it might.
That's everything. It's now or never.
All right, dragon. On the count of three. One. Two. Three!
Their gifts. With that many Christmas wishes coming true, there'll be enough magic to save Christmas for good.
Emmeline and Violet Ashworth.
Blossom Pike.
Pansy and Penny Brooks. Christian Andrews.
Amara Brienne.
Out of bed? Hoyt? Rand? Oh, where have you been? I have been worried sick.
You went to the north
to find Father Christmas.
There is no Father Christmas.
This is yours. This one's for you.
I've always wanted one. How did you know?
It's not from us. It's from him.
This is just like the one my mother had.
All the gifts have been delivered.
It's up to Aiden and the twins now to ring the bell.
I'll go see what's keeping.
Where's their Christmas spirit?
Angry mobs aren't exactly known for their goodwill.
Bring the beast!
Step aside.
You're gonna have to kill us first.
Yeah, what he said.
So be it.
No! Stop!
Out of the way, girl. This dragon is made for us to kill.
There's no need for violence. It's Christmas.
Christmas or not, that's a dragon.
Yeah.
I know all too well about the danger of dragons. It was a dragon that took my parents from me. But I was able to look past my fear. If we don't hurt them, they won't hurt us. It's just a young dragon. It's an orphan, like me.
Rand, Hoyt?
Thank you. Ring the bell!
Well, well, well. Looks like our Christmas wish came true. You going to come along quietly, or do you need persuading?
It's a young dragon now. The dragons go up.
Yeah!
And then what? Yeah! Then what?
Christmas is about forgiving and understanding. It reminds us to think of others instead of ourselves. This dragon saved our lives. And it helped us to live a Christmas.
What Christmas? There is no Christmas anymore.
Yeah!
You have to let her go. If someone doesn't ring that bell, there will never be another Christmas ever again.
Christmas. That's just a story for kids. Rosalind's too old to believe in that nonsense, isn't that right? If I let her go, she'd just run away to save herself.
Let us go and you'll find out.
You're going to need two hands to ring that bell. So what'll it be? Save yourself or save Christmas?
Rosalind, you have to believe.
Ring the bell and you're mine.
Thank you.
rest of them. Let go of them now!
My, oh my, this little one has spirit.
You. You're the reason my mother and father are dead. It's because of you that I'm an orphan.
Yes, I remember. You cost me a lot that day. I lost some good men and a good wagon. Time to repay me for all the trouble.
She is not going anywhere with you.
If you try to take her, that dragon will burn you to the ground.
Well, that can't happen, can it? A good dragon is a dead dragon.
Gazaret, born tall. Untie those children and release them to me.
Listen, old man, we've paid for the girl and we're already several days past her delivery. The rest we're taking for our trouble.
The only thing you'll be getting, Gazaret, Grimgrace, is justice. And you barely deserve that much. For your treachery, your thievery, your dishonesty, and most despicably, your attack on these children. I find you guilty and sentence you.
To what? What are you gonna do?
You are both banished. Leave this land and never, ever, ever return.
And if we do,
you'll have to deal with us.
All of us.
Yeah! Yeah!
Father, I know how angry you must be.
Yeah, it's all right. All is forgiven. Thank you for finding my son and bringing him home.
It wasn't me who found him. It was these children.
Rand, Hoyt, Roslyn, Finn, Aiden. My sincerest thanks. I'll not forget what you've done for me. Serwin, Herc, make sure Gazaret and Borntal have left for good. I'll see to it that these children get back home. What's wrong, child? Don't you want to go?
I just thought after all this, we wouldn't have to go back to the orphanage.
That's not your home anymore. Your home is with me now. For as long as you want. And that goes for the rest of you, too. I'm sure we can find 5 beds for Dusty to sleep in.
Christmas? Can I have one more Christmas wish?
Yes. We can pick up Geralt along the way.
Thank you.
family is what is most important in life. Be it formed of blood or of bond, when someone joins a family, they're bound together forever. They come to our rescue when we need it the most. With family, we have our saddest moments, but also our happiest. Family is one of God's greatest gifts to us, and we must honor it with all our heart throughout our life. And so, Serwin, with great joy, you are hereby joined with our family. Don't just stand there, boy. Kiss the girl.